Well, he wasn't anywhere today. The tactic, obviously, is to let this sort of cool down, hope it goes away. Is one of his escape roads, perhaps, if he comes out and throws a member of his staff under the bus and says, well, I told you I never rang Alan Joyce. My office might have. I've made some inquiries and, you know, someone, whoever it might be, well, they rang a number at Qantas. It wasn't direct to Alan Joyce and asked for the upgrade for me and he got it. Is that an escape route?
Well, wouldn't the best option here be the truth? I know that's always a novel thing in politics, but if he did call Alan Joyce at the time, more than a decade ago...
That may be what happened.
But he didn't say that yesterday when he was asked, did you personally call Alan Joyce? He danced around that answer and say, give me a specific allegation. If you didn't call him, I think it's pretty clear. You just say, I never called Alan Joyce. What was put in this book is wrong. We're 5 days now since this story broke and that hasn't been the claim. So let's see where this goes.
Caroline, what about this? We're all getting a bit sick and tired of hearing about the PM growing up in social housing, single car, you know, single mum. I mean, she obviously did a great job, but he keeps tossing that out, particularly when there's an election. When you've got a $4.3 million holiday house at Copacabana and you're flying first class on jets, that image takes a bit of a battering, doesn't it?
Yeah, I don't think a lot of us want to begrudge anyone who's done well in life. You know, that tall poppy syndrome, that's really one of the worst aspects, I think, of Australian culture. But I don't think that's what's happening here. I think you've got a politician who has made it basically his origin story to talk about how he came from public housing with a single mum. Okay, good on you. But now all of this apparent grifting in the form of these upgrades and the chairman's lounge membership for his son, it's not a good look for someone who keeps talking about how they came from the sticks and how they can appreciate what life is like for those people. And it turns out that voters are ready. It's doing not well at all with voters. A Redbridge focus group held last week before even the latest revelations about these Qantas upgrades came out, it found that most people found that thought that he was betraying his working class background, and they didn't like this, the purchase of this holiday home, in the slightest. So it's not going down well. The latest story this week about the flights is going to take him even further down in the public perception, and this is months out from a federal election. These optics are not good in the middle of a cost of living crisis, and just gives the impression that he may have come from a very modest background, but he certainly is enjoying the finer things in life now.
Georgie and Trudy, thanks very much for joining us tonight. Appreciate it.